May I invite Shri Susheel Kumar ji to kindly say a few words.
Honorable Governor Shri of Gujarat, distinguished colleagues on the dais, ladies and gentlemen, let me first of all welcome you to this event which will happen for 3 days on behalf of Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Government of India. When Dr. Kartikeya Sarabhai spoke to me and invited me for this conference, I very readily accepted it because, as you have already heard, this is probably the first such brainstorming session which we will have on implementing what we achieved in the year 2015. 2015 was a watershed year, I would feel, especially in the field of environment. The MDGs were replaced by SDGs, and the Kyoto Protocol was replaced by the Paris Agreement. Now, both these events are extremely significant and can alter the future course the globe takes. I hope that it does, because it's very closely linked with our future and the future of our children. And in that context, sessions like this acquire great importance. On the climate change front, we are going to meet for the first time in the month of May to discuss among the group of countries as to how to interpret the agreement for implementation post 2020 and how to go forward beyond 2020 up to 2100. Before that, if such events take place in all countries and in all provinces or states of those countries, I'm sure it will feed into the knowledge pool that the country delegations will bring to Bonn for discussions on climate change. Or similarly, on the sustainable development goals, on other ones, climate change is just one, which is goal number 13. But that's also, like education, a very cross-cutting theme in the SDGs. So education is one cross-cutting theme, climate change is another cross-cutting theme, and obviously at the core of all this is the concept of sustainability. I would like to convey to you that we in Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change have found educating even the ministry is quite difficult. As far as these SDGs are concerned, the process of evolving the SDGs was a very prolonged process. When we interacted with ministries, and CE was helping us in that, and they were spearheading the effort, the concept of sustainability has to actually sink in policy makers, in the people who implement the policies, and in people at large. If I were to divide the whole system into three parts: people who make policies, people who implement policies, and people who have to live with those policies. So governments generally handle the first two aspects of that, and first two parts of this system, The third part, where the major work lies, is something where a combined effort of government system and non-governmental system has to happen. So when I am just trying to convey to you that if we found this concept so difficult to be imbibed by the policy makers and the implementers, the concept to be imbibed by the people at large is going to be a much more difficult process. It's going to be a much prolonged process and would require a much prolonged action by all concerned. And that's where, if a clear roadmap emerges from sessions like this, it is going to be extremely helpful. Because this is I'm told that this is a mix of national and international, youth and experience, state and non-state actors, all of you are present here. So such sessions have the ability to transcend beyond boundaries of time, of age, of thought. So I really look forward to the outcome document which Karthikeya talked about, and we would like that more such sessions are held in different states. I'm told that the state representatives are also here. So if such sessions are held in the states and such sessions are also held by different ministries, that's really going to be of use for Government of India and all our state governments. As far as the sustainable development goals are concerned, the role of our ministry in a way is over, because now we have these 17 goals and 169 targets. The government is now grappling with developing the indicators. Now that's a very difficult task, and that's not going to be a standard piece. Each country is going to develop its own, and we are actually grappling with not only the indicators but also the time frames. Whether we can really achieve these in the time frames which are indicated. So that's what the government is doing. But how to bring it into the overall policy making, how to see that actually we achieve as a country all these sustainable goals, is going to be a combined effort of all of us. And I hope that when such sessions take place, they will all deliberate, and the outcome document of each of these, like the one that you are going to produce, is going to be extremely useful for all governments and for all of us. So I just wanted to again convey my best wishes, and I wanted to welcome you to this. I hope that's going to be a useful session for all of you, and we will all go back well educated on how to achieve these SDGs in the time frames that I stipulated. Thank you very much.